Hello, this is Charles from PlumbingSupply.com. Today we're going to give you a basic rundown on how to join PVC pipe to a joint or another union of sorts. The first thing you're going to want to do is gather your tools, pipe cutters, depending on the size of the materials you're going to be using, or if you go really big, you may want to get a saw. You're going to want clean towels because things may get messy at times. You're going to want to be able to wipe up an area if you get a little bit of solvent or glue where you don't want it. And also you're going to want your primer. Purple is often used to indicate that primer has been applied to a joint or a fitting or a piece of pipe that's being connected. So that's pretty handy. Then we also have our Christie's Red Hot Blue Glue that we're going to use today. And that's basically all you need other than the materials that you're going to be connecting to make the joint. So first thing you want to do is the most critical thing, or one of the most critical things, is making sure you have a square cut. That's where most joint failures occur, is that the cut is beveled or there's burrs in here. So you want a clean square cut there so that it butts into the joint really well. And when it butts into the joint, you want it to go at least a third of the way to two-thirds of the way into the joint. So that being said, we've already pre-cut our pipe here and our joint is ready to go, ready cleaned, and basically ready to apply the primer. You want to have all your tools and everything in very close proximity to the work area. You need to work rapidly. This stuff dries pretty quickly. Once you get the primer on there, it starts activating, or it starts working on the surface of the plastic here, which actually softens the PVC itself here and here, which helps the glue adhere to it, which really gives you a strong joint. So first off, we'll go ahead and take the primer, and I like to have the tops of my materials kind of open and ready to go. As long as it's not for extended periods of time, that should be okay, or else they will start to harden. I take my primer here, and I'm actually going to do my 90 here, my socket first, and you give it a nice liberal amount, and you want to make sure that when you're doing this, you just try to not get it back into the joint or the fitting, so kind of hold it forward, and just again, apply a liberal amount. When doing this, try to get a dauber that's at least half the diameter of the material you're using. So in this case, this dauber is obviously sufficient size here. So I'm going to sit that there, set it down. I'm also going to prime up my fitting here. And while doing this, like I said, you could apply it liberally. Just make sure it's really good on there. You're also cleaning off any dirt or debris that might be on the pipe itself. Set that down there. And when doing this, like I said, you kind of want to work fast. Apply a very generous amount here. Again, holding it forward. This is another point where seals will fail, not having enough of this solvent and the primer on there. So while the solvent's wet, you want to apply while the primer's wet, you want to apply the solvent. And just give it a nice spin there. Set that down. Do my pipe as well. And again, a nice liberal amount. You want to really gob it on there. So at this point, you want to take your joint and snugly press it into the fitting till it butts up. Give it about a quarter turn so it really seats itself. And what you're looking for is a nice bead all the way around that joint there. As long as you got that, you're going to have a pretty sure seal. And again, like I said, you could take some towels and clean up if you're going for a, uniform look there. But that's basically it. You're going to want to examine the joint, make sure it's butted up in the rear here. Make sure the glue, like I said, makes a nice bead all the way around the seal. And, hold it together. Make sure it's set there for about 30 seconds. And you should be good to go. And everybody, when you do this, make sure you're in a well-ventilated area. These chemicals are pretty potent. You don't want to breathe them in for long periods of time. They're also flammable, so be very careful where you use them and what you're around when you are using them. Again, I recommend a very well-ventilated area if you do have to do this indoors. So again, this is Charles from PlumbingSupply.com. You can find more helpful videos like this on our website. Thank you for watching.